If you haven't watched the previous videos, discharge debt successfully as a secured creditor, go and watch that video for proof of discharge. Well, this video right here is going to show you how to properly respond if the alleged creditor says that we don't accept that type of payment. Listen, folks, you do not need to go to court. If someone's telling you you need to go to court, they've exhausted all of their resources. That's been ineffective. If you go to court, you're going to be the one going to court to bring a lawsuit against the alleged creditor.
Oh, read it. So-and-so credit union wishes to extend the following offer to you. The current payoff of your account is $1,696.32. We're willing to accept a lump sum settlement of $678.52. Upon receipt of payment, we will notify the three creditors, credit bureaus to which we report, Experian, Equifax, and TransUnion, that the matter has been settled in full. And she actually gives a phone number. Now,
so as you see, an account that has already been settled and closed, still have a particular lady that's actually been right. So I'm therefore going to take that task upon myself and take care of it. So I've actually constructed a letter today that I intend to mail out to this lady that's actually claiming or pretending to be a part of the original creditor. And I'll read you some of it, and it's worded like this. To whom it may concern, and I know her name, so I'll put her name there. This letter is being sent to you in response to a notice sent to me on March the 12th, 2012. Be advised that this is not a refusal to pay, but a notice sent pursuant to the Fair Debt Collection Practice Act 15 USC 1692G Section 809B, that your claim is disputed and validation is requested. I conditionally accept your offer upon proof of claim that this debt has not already been set off, settled, and closed. This is not a request for verification or proof of my mailing address, but a request for your validation made pursuant to the above named title and section. I respectfully request your office provide me with the competent evidence that I have any legal obligation to pay you. Please provide me with the following. And I listed it as such. What the money you say I owe is for, explain and show me how you calculated what you say I owe, provide me with copies of any paper that show I agree to pay what you say I owe, show me the contract that I have with you, provide a verification or copy of any judgment, if applicable, identify the original creditor, prove the statute of limitation has not expired on this account, show me that you are licensed to collect in my state, provide me with your license number and registered agent. At this time, I will also inform you that if your office has reported and validated information to any of the three major credit bureaus, Equifax, Experian, and TransUnion, this action may constitute fraud under the federal and state laws. Due to this fact, if any negative marks is found on any of my credit reports by your company or the company that you represent or represent, I will not hesitate to bring legal action against you for the following: violation of the Fair Credit Reporting Act, violation of the Fair Debt Collection Practice Act, defamation of character. And if your office are able to provide the proper documentations as required in the following declaration, I will require at least 30 days to investigate the information, and during such time, all collections activity must cease and desist. Basically, in a nutshell, take off my reading glasses here, the accepted for value does work. And when bird brains come at me like this, lawyers come at me like this that work for credit agencies on debts that has already been set off, settle, and close, I conditionally accept your offer upon proof of claim that you show me the statute where you can continue to try and collect on a debt that's already set off, settled, and closed. And that's how you deal with that, brothers and sisters. Once again, my name is Tazadok, and I say shalom to you all.